secrets.
Thank you.
Done it in this moment.
and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Good morning.
You're all very welcome this morning on this, the feast of the body and blood of Christ. I think we have to realise that after the Ascension, the Church essentially becomes the body of Christ in the world, but only through this action that we carry out today and every time we celebrate Mass. It's only in the breaking of the bread and the sharing of the cup that we become the body of Christ in the world, that we become the messengers of the good news. So aware both of the challenge and the responsibility and the blessing that comes from the Eucharist. We'll just pause for a wee moment now, quietly to come into God's presence. In preparation for our celebration, we call to mind our sins and ask God's pardon. I confess
to Almighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have committed sin, and my thoughts and words, and what I have done and what I have failed to do, in my life, in my fault, in my fault, in my mysterious fault. Therefore, I ask that the Spirit of the Virgin, all the angels,
forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Thank you.
God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
The first reading is taken from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how the Lord your God led you for 40 years in the wilderness to humble you, to test you, and know your inmost heart, whether you would keep his commandments or not. He humbled you. He made you feel hunger. He fed you with manna, which neither you nor your fathers had known, to make you understand that man does not live on bread alone, but that man lives on everything that comes from the mouth of the Lord. Do not then forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, who guided you through this vast and dreadful wilderness, a land of fiery serpents, scorpions, thirst, who in this waterless place brought you water from the hardest rock, who in this wilderness fed you with manna that your fathers had not known." The word of the Lord.
Taste and see that the Lord is good. Come and eat my bread. Come and drink my wine. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Come and eat my bread. Come and drink my wine. I will bless the Lord at all times, God's praise always on my lips. In the Lord my soul shall make its boast, the humble shall hear and be glad. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Come and eat my bread. Come. Join with me in praise of God's name. Together sing glory. I sought the Lord and he answered. From terror he brings me release. Oh, taste and see. Come and drink. Look to the Lord and let your face shine. The poor shall cry out and be helped. Oh, look to the Lord and be radiant. God rescues from torment and grief. Oh, it is thy sea that the Lord is good. Come and drink
my wine.
Angels of God are near to God's throne, surrounding in love God's people. Oh, taste and see the Lord is gracious, enfolding in love all who seek Him. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Come and eat my bread. Come and drink my wine.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. The blessing cup that we bless is a communion with the blood of Christ, and the bread that we break is a communion with the body of Christ. The fact that there is only one loaf means that though there are many of us, we form a single body because we all have a share in this one loaf. This is the word of the Lord.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
I am the living bread which has come down from heaven, says the Lord. Anyone who eats this bread will live forever.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jews, I am the living bread which has come down from heaven. Anyone who eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I shall give is my flesh for the life of the world. Then the Jews started arguing with one another. How can this man give us his flesh to eat? They said. Jesus replied, I tell you most solemnly, if you do not eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you will not have life in you. Anyone who does eat my flesh and drink my blood has eternal life, and I shall raise him up on the last day. For my flesh is real food, and my blood is real drink. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood lives in me, and I live in him. As I, who am sent by the living Father, myself draw life from the Father, so whoever eats me will draw life from me. This is the bread come down from heaven, not like the bread our ancestors ate. They are dead. But anyone who eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord. I feel inclined to say very little this morning, because I think that St. John has expressed way beyond anything I could ever do what we are about this morning. But above all, I think St. Paul absolutely nails it in in a very few lines, sharing in the one loaf, the oneness of the body of Christ. The feast, the Eucharist itself, is an action. It's not a place for spectators. It's only a place for participants. You're not here to see me doing something. I simply perform a function at the behest of the community. But the community, effectively, you know, is the dynamic of this great sacrament. We come here to be in communion with each other in Christ, empowered by the Spirit, and it's all pure gift from the Father. It brings us to our whole purpose in life. Our whole purpose in life is to be the body of Christ in the world. And that's only possible through participation, full participation in this sacrament. And let's just reflect on that. Let's stand now as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. At the the behest of Jesus, instructed by Jesus, we come before our Heavenly Father to place our needs firmly into His hands. Mass today is offered for all the people of the parishes, and we pray that we may truly learn to celebrate the Eucharist, to become the body of Christ in the world. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for Bishop Taylor that God will continue to comfort and support him at this time. Lord, in your mercy. We pray too for the continuing recovery of Pope Francis. Lord, in your mercy. Let's pray for justice and for peace in our world. Lord, in your mercy. And we pray for all the faithful departed, that they may enjoy eternal happiness in God's presence. Lord, in your mercy. Father in heaven, these are our prayers placed into your hands in faith. We ask that you receive them, and if it's your will, that you grant them through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings we here present, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished Lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful by this sacred mystery, you make them holy, so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united by one bond of charity. And so we approach the table of this wondrous sacrament, so that, bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the host of angels, cry out, and without end we acclaim.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, the Order of Bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint John the Evangelist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you all. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Soul of my Savior, sanctify my breath. Defend me from the foe.